Okay. Trying to get the game audio as loud as it'll go without me clipping out. But I clip easily now, so as long as I don't yell. Welcome to the chat room. Looks like early morning. The ennui of this game. Hey, Toxie. It's funny you should mention that, because that is one of the game's strengths. It gets you used to just chilling and nothing happening. And then when something does happen, it's an event. Last time I played, I heard something banging around in this air conditioning duct. Shortly after I received a communication. Are you calling me Michael because I called you Toxie and that's not your name? And Michael's not my name? Let me just look at my details here. It's 4 a.m., so yeah, it's about to be morning. And now, the game should be loud enough to where you can hear this rumbling sound. That's the actual audio signal coming in off the antenna.
Good morning, good afternoon, and welcome to the
really eschew the name. You want to be Beast World now. That Toxie is a dead name. If you hear that, that triggers you. What am I doing? I'm just gonna assess the situation here. I see that my door is unlocked. I think when you first start the game, all the doors start unlocked. Are the crickets loud enough for you? I come out here and sometimes I'll see planets. Oh, there's the moon going down. I think Toxie has committed some crimes that Beast World would rather not be associated with. Thought crimes, but crimes nonetheless. What was that game I used to play all the time? My Summer Car. Somebody said that this is a lot like My Summer Car. Where's my cart? I have a golf cart. Somewhere, I don't know where it is. Oh, where the fuck did it go? There it is. It's by the Cybertruck.
Gain a deeper understanding of the many fantastic things NASA is undertaking for the nation. We'll all hold our breath together as we watch our dedicated team of scientists and engineers work to land Curiosity on Mars on Sunday night. Depending on where you are, this NASA social isn't just about Curiosity on Mars. I'm particularly excited about it because it highlights...
Yeah, Fleetery fucking stole the cart. All right, it's time to start scanning. Oh, while I was out there, I should have cleaned off the, I'm going back out there. Gotta clean the solar panels. Is that, I don't know what temperature that is, but it feels like it's probably in the 60s or 70s Fahrenheit. I hear something. I think it's this thing. The hottest curry. Hey man, I love the way hot spicy food opens my sinuses. Like red curry, it's incredible. And now I've been doing the breathe right strips. All my life I've had a stuffy nose. I never knew that I could breathe this well and it's these fucking breathe right strips, man. It's completely changed my world. Like, I have dreams again. Like, I've not been having dreams. And now, with the breathe right strips, like, my brain is getting proper oxygen. So that's kind of scary to think that all this time. All right, whatever. Let's get some fucking scanning. Said he doesn't pay me for nothing. So yeah, I gotta do the breathe right strip after some red curry and see what that's like. I just ate a gummy bear. I got a cup of coffee here. I got a can of Mountain Dew. I got a thing of water. I'm sucking and fucking right now. Like, I'm ready to go. I know this is loud. It's loud for me. I don't know what that is. I don't really know. I just know that I have to track the frequency here. And then it starts coming in over here. And then I get the average azimuth calculation and elevation, but to get an even better one, I can go over here, divert power to the coordinates system, and I can get a little bit tighter. But for now, I'm gonna set it to 35. I try to go low so that I can dial it in easier. The lowest it shows me is 33 so far. And then go low over here too. 20 was the lowest. Alright. And then I go ahead to save power, I go ahead and switch that off. I get back up. I keep that going. I go over here, divert all my power to the antenna so that they turn faster because they've got some turning to do. And now they're turning. We could even get up and, it's having a nice rain, and watch them turn. You can see them rotating. Was he going off on the... It does sound like a person's voice. I don't know if that's just interference from ground-based radio or what that is. Toxie, it's good to have you, man. It's nice to talk to you again, even if it is somewhat one way. I never heard it called boiling a cigarette. See, I've turned the game audio up considerably because audio is such an important part of this game, but I'm afraid that it's gonna like be too bad. I have been smoking the same bowl for like 2 weeks now. I just take gummies. Now you'll see that once we lock it in here, this audio signal is going to change from this rumbling, which is, it's just picking up the cosmic background radiation. It's going to change from a rumbling to like a to whatever the signal actually is over here. All right, so we're almost done moving the antenna, and then the signal strength monitor over here is what we'll go by. So I've already got part of the azimuth. I've gotten so good at tuning this thing in. Azimuth is locked in. Now, I start dialing this up. The elevation. Oh, I need to divert power back to the coordinates. Helicopter's coming in to deliver fuel and other supplies. I don't know how to use the supplies. I know how to use the fuel, but I don't know how to use all the other supplies they bring. Oh, there it is. Got it. So we're starting to download it, but I'm going to keep dialing it in, get it a little better. Okay, now I divert power from the coordinate system to the server to maximize my download speed. Oh shit, the server's getting hot. So I go in the terminal. Turbo. How hot is 65 Celsius? That's pretty hot, right? You don't want your server that hot. The download speed is excellent. So we're downloading. This is coming off of a Blue Giant star. It's a radio wave emission. So it's probably just gonna be garbled nonsense. But that can lead to upgrades, module upgrades. I've got great download speed now. So it's converting it to binary. Just takes a couple seconds. And it's just garbled data. but it upgraded a module. It's storming now. I like to look and see what got updated. A sub-reflector, maybe?
All my life, I've wondered about life
the solar panels
beyond the Earth.
So my solar panels got an upgrade. That's cool.
That we think circle of, is there also life? Might the beings of other worlds resemble us, or would they be astonishingly different? What would they be made of? In the vast Milky Way galaxy, how common is what we call life?
So lightning hits something. And the quest for life and the computers are resetting.
Are two sides of the same question.
All right. Why is it in centigrade? Because I'm a scientist?
All living things on Earth.
Why is
are made
centigrade and Celsius interchangeable? They're not different, are they? They're the same, right?
Built around atoms of carbon. In the great dark arc between the stars, there also are organic molecules. Oh.
Let's see. I can upgrade some stuff.
And dust. And inside such clouds, there are batches of new worlds just forming. Their surfaces are very likely covered with organic molecules. These molecules almost certainly are not made by life, although they are the stuff of life.
My servers are getting hot, so I upgraded the server so it won't generate as much heat.
Same chemistry.
All right, let's get another signal going here. I like how everything's got an audio, a volume dial and shit. Such a cool game.
The origin and evolution of life is inevitable on every clement world.
Just point it to a spot in the sky and start scanning. Okay, Toxie. Get yourself straight, baby.
Cosmic, as elaborate and complex as we, able to explore the mystery and origins. Let me tell you a story.
Hello, Yeet.
Newly lost. The surviving Hickey warriors.
Yeet, how's it going, man? Okay, this is an unknown signal source. It's a fast radio burst. Don't know what it's gonna be like. How's life in Charlotte, dude? You got any gossip? You got any news? You guys get your vaccine shots yet? Brian, sorry I missed your message, dude. Sometimes the shit drops out because of my VPN. Today I just started. This is my second signal. It's a weird one. It's just gonna be some bullshit, I think. But we're decoding it now.
Threw themselves into the sea and drowned.
Yeah, nothing.
The Emperor's grandmother, the Lady Ni, resolved that they would not be captured by the enemy. What happened next is related.
But I'm getting good at scanning these down fast.
The young Emperor asked the Lady Ni,
like really fast now,
"Where are you to take me?" She turned to the youthful sovereign with tears streaming down her cheeks and comforted him. Blinded with tears, the child sovereign put his beautiful small hands together.
We playing Sea of Thieves tonight?
To the east to say farewell to the god of Issei, and then to the west to recite the Nembutsu, a prayer to the Amida Buddha. The Lady Ni took him in her arms, and with the words, "In the depths of the ocean is our capital," sank with him at last beneath the waves.
$7.75. See how fast I'm getting these?
Only 43 Heikki survived, all women. These former ladies-in-waiting of the Imperial Court were reduced to selling flowers and other favors.
Other favors.
These women, by the fisher folk, established a festival to commemorate the battle. To this day, every year, on the 24th of April, their descendants proceed to the Akama Shrine, which contains the mausoleum the drowned 7-year-old emperor, Antoku. There, they conduct a ceremony of remembrance for the life and death of the Heikki warriors. But there's a strange postscript to this story. The fishermen say that the Heikki samurai wander the bottom of the inland sea still, in the form of crabs. There are crabs to be found here which have curious markings on their backs, patterns which resemble a human face with the aggressive scowl of a samurai warrior from medieval Japan.
Oh, it's calibration number 17. We'll go out there after this one.
sea crabs, when caught, are not eaten. They're thrown back into the sea in commemoration of the doleful events of the Battle of Dano-Ura.
Your war zone is broken. What went wrong? What happened to Warzone? Is it on PC? Are we playing Sea of Thieves tonight? You should play Sea of Thieves. It's a four-player game, and we could use a fourth individual. Let's see. I don't know where to go from here. Can't go too much lower. Minimum, so I gotta go up now. I have not downloaded it yet, no, but I'll download it soon. I've got it pretty fast. I just uninstalled GTA 5 so I would have room for it. I gotta get a fucking SSD, man, like a terabyte or two or something. 78.7. Which way was I going? Down. No, I already went this direction. It's supposed to be right in here. Nice. Brian, can we play cross-platform with him? All he needs is our Xbox Microsoft names, right? All right, I think I know mine. I'm gonna go real high on this. I'm going all the way up to 88 here. And I'm just gonna make my way down because I've looked through the whole band. There's that sound. There's that creepy sound. I heard it just once, just for a second. I don't think you could hear it. I'm finding it. Here we go. All right. Divert all the power to the server. Nine megabytes per second. Tristan, how the hell are you? Yeah, probably a full playthrough, I would say, yes. I'm trying to get my fourth story signal here. I never played the game before, so don't spoil it for me. Or I'll have you mutilated. I'll make you walk the plank. I hated those fucking sea shanties that everybody was posting on Twitter. That shit can suck my dick. I'm edgy. Yeah, this is a weird one, dude. What is this? Unknown source, radio wave emission. Yeah, it's a weird one. Don't spoil this game. Because he came in here talking about full playthrough, like he knows what's going on. Like somebody came in here the other day and asked me if I found a dead body. So now I'm expecting a dead body at some point. Which is crazy because this just doesn't seem like a game where you'd find a dead body. Here we go, decode this motherfucker. It's another random one. Okay. Something else you can do, though. Like, if you're not happy with what you're finding here, you can, at the very least, run your signal analyzer, and it will analyze the signals that you've been finding. And sometimes they contain module schematics, a way of upgrading systems here. Nothing. All right. So, all right. I got to go out and calibrate the antenna while there's still daylight. I can do some shit here. I can run the bio ink. All right. And that diverts all the power to the servers, and it runs this program that analyzes stuff to get my modules upgraded. And so while that's happening, I go out here. Oh, I forgot which one. It was number 17, that's right. Which is way out that way. And to calibrate these, you just go up on them. Oh, shit. I forgot to set them to their service points. I can't actually climb up on them. Sun's going down, too, so this is like a bad time to start that. Maybe what I can do is I can just go to sleep. Sleep through this night. And then everything here should be cool, right? Yeah. Oh, I've got some systems running that don't need to be. I can save power here. There we go. Oh, and before I do this, I'll set the rover where it needs to go. My Microsoft name should be Thornier Drake 86, like a thorny bush, but Thornier or Thornier, however you want to pronounce it. The French way of pronouncing it would be Thornier. Thornier. Let's see. Rover. Now you can upgrade the rover, but I don't see any point. It's very quiet in here. You can probably hear the police outside. Okay. Oh, it's freezing out. That's good. Good for the servers. It's 3:30. Whatever. Yeah, the system's draining power. So I will clean the solar panels again once I'm outside. I've never played Sea of Thieves. I think I've seen all of about 2 minutes of gameplay footage of it, and it looks cool. Looks fun. I was watching somebody's ship sink, and they were, like, running up and down with a bucket. Shit, I still forgot to move the... I still forgot to move the... antenna. Oh, 17 is fixed. It's like back to calibrated. That's weird. I still gotta go out and fix it. Everything else is cool though. Oh, antenna 8 is not responding. So maybe during the power outage, antenna 8 went out. So I gotta go turn antenna 8 back on. Right by my building, and then go to 17. Look, I don't know why there are locks on the doors, but I assume they're there for a reason. I can crush myself by like getting in the gears here where it's It's coming around. See how it comes around? It's about to let me on. I don't know why it's sending a timeout. I guess I just have to reboot the server in here. It's Yeet. Yeet, have you been going in the Beast World stream? Was he playing Lord of the Rings? Every time I see a reference to the Lord of the Rings movies, I want to burn incense and smoke pot and watch Lord of the Rings all the way through. But then if I actually try and do that, I get so fucking bored. I'm like, and then I get lost. I'm like, this white-haired wizard looks just like anybody else. What's the big deal? And before you know it, they're in some kind of big fucking mountain. And my axe. They never lit my world on fire. You mean the Beast World streams. They did not give you that hit of serotonin or dopamine that you were looking for. You know, I just feel pressure whenever the numbers get big. I'm like, oh God, it's too big. 4 is a good number for me. So here's number 17. I thought 17 was fucked. Is this not 17? Oh, this is 18. There's that fucking orb. I feel the same about Hate Radio. It's so interesting to me that I can run these game streams. Nobody gives a fuck, you know? But then Hate Radio comes on, and they're like, oh my God, and people that I haven't seen in 2 months will be there chatting and participating, sucking dicks. I don't need to do that. They like them some culture, but they don't care for those games. Jamie Cochran used to call them screen games, and she would laugh at me. I'm glad there aren't as many crazy people here. They can leave all that life ruination hard chats. behind. Yeah, she called them screen games because they're like games that you play on a screen. She was not a gamer. She loved my video games, and she would like retweet my Euro Truck Simulator streams because I would just be doing a podcast while playing Euro Truck Simulator, basically. And but that was really the extent of her appreciation for gaming. There's 15. I'll just check the calibration on these as I'm going. I'm not gonna do them all, just the trouble spots. That's kind of how I do this. 15 needed it, so it's a good thing I stopped here. And then I gotta hit number 4. Really just number 4. 10 and 4 is all I need to hit, and I'm done. What format are you referring to? The, like the Euro Truck Simulator, just talking out of your ass while you're playing? Yeah, because the reason you would watch this is not because you need to see the game get played. Like, if you were going to do that, you'd just play it yourself or fucking watch a silent Let's Play. But, yeah, you want to hear the person. But people take that too far. Like, there's this, here. There's this fucking trend of people in YouTube who will, who will do these videos and like just cut their fucking videos so that there's no gap at all of silence or not speaking. It's just speaking straight, like this guy.
Oh no, I killed the bear legit. I can kill these fellas, I think. Thanks for helping me out, man. It's about time. You get like a really good sword from this quest, so yeah, let's do it. I don't know if Blood Moon is finished in this mod. We'll have to see. I'm not sure what your business is out here in the wild, but I'm glad you're not one of my Skull brothers. Oh, you're a coward. Alright, so this guy is supposed to like kill a Draugr, and he can't.
Do you hear how... Dude, these are jump cuts. I mean, it's like significant portions of the game, and then he's just here, he's there. There's not a second. The guy just won't take a... It sounds like he won't take a breath. And he would have a charming personality, a nice voice, if he would just fucking leave a little space in there. But the way it is it just makes him sound insufferable. That's number 2, 3, 4. I understand what you're saying, Beast, because I have the same feelings about it. Like, commodifying. Like, that's the reason I don't do the face cam. Like, that's just a step I'm not willing to go. That takes it one step too far. Commodifying things that, like, girlfriends, for example, have said that they... I like it when you do that thing with your eyes. It's a funny expression. Like, you know, I can tell that things like that endear me to them. But I don't want to commodify that. I don't want to turn that into some, like, figure it out and use that. You know, that's weird. And, like, Twitch offered me partner on both channels. And that's just something for them to take away from you. So, like, no thanks, you know? But, like, then it becomes, yeah. So, me twiddling these knobs, it's no longer this experience of me, like, doing something just for love of the game. It's... It's this whole capitalistic sort of drive that is built into society at this point. Like, anytime I would be... Come on, motherfucker. like troubleshooting a computer or playing music really well. And like my grandpa would hear it, he'd say, "Son, you're pretty good at that. Maybe you'll make a living of it one day." It's like, why? Why everything that I enjoy should I turn it into a fucking product and pimp it out? Like, it's not, you know, it's not the Great Depression anymore where you can't rub two nickels together. It's not that serious. You can do things and just enjoy them. And, yeah, as a little kid, dude, I always loved people, like, standing behind me and watching me play a video game. It was like, I lived for that little bit of attention. And, but that's enough. Like, I don't need to turn that into money. Like, there's cam whores that do it just for the love of the game. They don't want to make money. They just like being sluts on the internet, you know? What if my grandpa... "Son, you're pretty good at jerking off on a computer screen. Why don't you do that full time?" Like, it's not that bad. My life is okay without doing that. And I think that's why I always liked comedy so much more than everything else, because I forgot what I'm looking for. Was 10 the one I needed to touch? Yeah, I guess it was. Well, I like comedy because you have to do some writing ahead of time to create it. Like, yeah, you can be spontaneously funny and access that anytime. There goes my stuff. They're lowering it into the house. But there's magic about making something written, having it ready, bringing it out. It's like, it is inherently, it's transactional, and it's like a, there's just something about it. So, like, I always liked that about it. Like, it's really cut and dry. There's no bullshit about it. Like, no, I wrote this ahead of time to make you laugh, and this is my product. Like, that's all right by me. That's all pretty cut and dry. But morphing something that I grew up loving, like music or video games, into a commodity, that's... Music is different too, because I'm used to making money from music, like playing in Nashville and shit. Like, I liked that a lot. That was validating, so that was cool too. But yeah, just playing video games, like, why turn that into a job, dude? Like, that guy Robos, he's fucking hilarious. I love him. And I really admire the way that guy can just commit to the schedule. And he plays video games for a living. That's fucking awesome. But I couldn't do it. Like, you gotta respect that man's endurance. All right, let's see what we got going on here. Oh, this is cool. How's my... Oh, that server is cooking. Let's turn the fans here. All right. And... everything's looking good here. Welcome back, Yeet. Oh, thanks, Beast World. I'm naturally funny. I really love going to that place and just being silly and goofy. Yeah, you do. If it's a game like Counter-Strike Global Offensive, there's no role play there. People are watching you for a different reason, I believe. But in this game, it's entirely your narrative. I mean, look, I'm running Cosmos over here. You can, like, turn the radio on. It's unique every time. Oh, this is the structure of the universe here he's showing.
Everything you need to know on how to make a human being is encoded in the
language
of life, in the DNA molecule.
Hidden menace. That's hilarious.
This is the DNA double helix, a machine with about 100.
That's funny. I wonder how many people hear that. Oh, this hidden menace. That's hilarious. It's probably true. Because there is some people have told me that I sound permanently sarcastic. I don't mean to. I'm just, you know, just being playful, just being silly, constantly. Hold on, let me check my calibration and everything. That was a sloppy calibration run, but still, I think, yeah, that's pretty good. That all looks fine. Number one, I should have visited one, but whatever. I was right by it. Anyway. Yeah, Beast World, I think about that sometimes too. And also, I noticed that, like, maybe in the olden times, it was good that there was a limited number of spaces on TV and on the stage. It's like there's only so many roles. Because now that everybody, like now that it's social media, and now that everybody is their own little media mogul, there's this fucking, there's this narcissism that is like way more prevalent than used to be. Like, it didn't used to be that everybody had that burning passion in them to be noticed and recognized and everybody clapping for you, cheering for you, that there is now. And it's kind of in everybody. And it makes everybody think that they're better than each other and selective and throw each other away. Like, everybody's just can so easily throw each other away now. Throw it away, throw it away, throw it away now. And, it's kind of sick, dude. And not, like, sick in a good way. But let me turn this shit off. All right, performance would have been more common, yeah, but even still, a limited space. I'm still thinking about your previous comments. High compliments, really. Okay. Turn the server off. Pick up my coordinates. I have to compare the chats sometimes against each other because one chat will get all the messages. Power to the antennas and get those puppies spinning. This is the fastest they've ever turned. Shadow puppets. Yeah, it's only as toxic as your awareness is lacking, I think. It's like, this is just good fun. But if I was to take myself more seriously, like, that would be, you know, there would be zero people instead of three, because, like, you know, I'm lucky enough that there's two people in this world that that want to hang out with me and fucking play this game together, rather than looking at it like, oh, there's only two people here, like, how am I gonna, like, oh, I'm gonna lose my partnership. You know, hey guys, like and subscribe. Am I thinking of the big ape cultures? I don't know what that means. I'm gonna put on a different video over here. Whoa, that guy's really got his music going. Oh, here we go. Right, so they've stopped turning. I can flip that off. Where am I at? 103 and 40. Okay. All power to the coordinates. All power to the coordinates. I did not realize Curtainer had started streaming. I've had my head up my own ass in my own misery over here. Oh, I'm finding these signals so fast. Whoa, this is a tight one. Okay, we should be downloading. Why am I not downloading? Oh. There it goes. Cool. A rogue planet. I think that's a planet that has strayed from its solar system, if I'm not mistaken. And do I cultivate my voice? I think I'm just aware of my voice. I try to listen to what the words sound like coming out of my mouth. Nibiru. We haven't heard from I'm Friendly in a while. Listen to Yeet. Keeping the conversation going, asking how everybody's doing. We haven't heard from so-and-so. Yeet, I met somebody from North Carolina that doesn't believe in the virus and thinks that... And Bill Gates come up in the conversation. I have to apologize if I don't properly address every comment here. When I think of cultivating a voice, completely Yes, yes, I think I did that. I think I started doing that at an early age. I went to kindergarten and I was reading a book. This is like one of my first days at school, and or maybe it was first grade. It was kindergarten. And I was reading a book, not my first day, but I had been there for a while, I think. And this kid goes, "You can read that?" And I said, "Yeah." And I'm thinking in my mind, like, weird question. And he goes, "You're a lion." And I'm like, "What?" This is North Carolina, by the way. I said, "I'm not a jungle cat." In my mind, I'm thinking that. And he's like, "You're a lion." And then I realize, oh, because he can't read, he assumes I can't read, and therefore I must be lying. And he's so fucking ignorant. The way he says you're lying is, "You're a lion. A lion." All right, so that was a random planet there. We got some module schematics downloaded. I always like to check and see what it was. And it was from that point on, I was like, oh yeah, like the way you say a word is as important as like how it's spelled or, you know, how other people hear it. So my fucking solar cells are just even better. This is cool. All right. What was my recharge rate? An additional 3%. That's getting big. Like, I've got all my systems running, and in the regular daylight, this shit is charging its way up back to butthole standards. Yeet knows what I'm talking about.
Still at large. The fugitive is known to be a...
Cloudy with a 30% chance.
White male. I'm thinking, God, 180 pounds, something like that. About, he had a buckle, a very large.
Various body parts in his wake. Please.
If I knew you were coming, I'd bake the cake. Bake the cake. Bake.
But you can go back in the hate show. You can hear hate radio. And you can hear a little bit of the South in my voice. Just a little bit. Especially like the 2016 one where I had been there just a little too long and it was about time to come to New York, like April 2017-ish. That was, because what you have to do to talk to old people, wherever you're from, is kind of talk at their cadence, at their pace, and even pronouncing the words that they pronounce. That's the only way they can hear them, sometimes. Burning my mouth out with this Dermaka myrrh. I read mom too, and I thought you said burning my mom out. I like to upgrade my coordinate detection above all the others. And I never use tracking. I don't know what it's for. I just always do it myself. That's the first upgrade I've wanted that I can't afford. Okay. So, we got all power to the coordinate system. Let me check on the rover real quick. He's making his way. Dixie is a different country to the US. Yeah, yeah. They were their own country at one time. You know? When people talk about, wow, the South is like another country, yes, that was the idea. Sometimes I think maybe they should have been. I'm just glad that they're not, because there would be so much bullshit trying to go from North to South. Just going from a different, like, America to Canada is enough bullshit, but you just know the South is so petty that they would make it, like, impossible to get out. It would be like North Korea. What am I doing? Checking my... Hey, that gummy bear is kicking in. Let's see. Oh, what's my temperature? Getting high. Better hit the turbo again. I like you can run these fans hard. What's that sound? What is this? This nuclear thing is going off. Is that a Geiger counter? Is there something near me? Maybe I should take a bath. Maybe I'm covered in radiation. Let's see if that took off the radiation. No, I'm still radioactive. Something is. Why can't I pick that up and carry it around? Oh, that's so... Dude, this game is super creepy. I never even... Oh, I didn't know I could zoom in like that. Oh my goodness. That changes everything. Oh, that's great. The zooming. I can watch TV better.
Isn't she beautiful? She's just so precious. We are so happy for you guys.
I can't tell you how honored we are that you chose us to be your godparents.
Oh, we wouldn't have picked anyone else but you two.
Every day when I look at her, I just think how lucky we are to have such a sweet angel.
Yeah. Has she been sleeping? Oh, she's so good. I'll put her down at 7 and she doesn't get up till around 11.
That's great. She's beautiful.
Thank you.
And big.
She's a healthy eater.
I've noticed that when the audio desyncs like that, I can pause it for a few minutes, hang out, and then it fixes it. So anyway, the Geiger counter's going. I'm just gonna run another scan. I don't know why the Geiger counter has to fucking troll me right now. Dude, all these comedians left LA that I was following and went to North Carolina and Texas and Arizona and stuff. Certain people stayed who I have always liked, though, like Scott Aukerman, I'm pretty sure, stayed in L.A. People like him. But yeah, the America, it's special. It's a special country. Everybody in the world's watching it. Let's see. Dial this in. My Geiger counter is creeping me out, man. I'm getting cancer out here. Alright. Have a sip of coffee while those are coming in. In the game and in real life. So 256 and 19. It's got a little speaker on it too that's like different from the clicking. 256, 21. Alright, that's good enough. Because it's got a little speaker on it, like somebody might talk to me through it one day. So we got them turning. You can hear shit coming out of the speaker. Yeet lives a life of leisure. 256, 24. This is looking good. Go ahead and switch that off. Servers are a good temperature. There's that sound! I think it's the alien that's radioactive. And it's near me right now. Was it funny, Yeet, when they fell down the stairs?
I can't believe she's only 3 months old.
We're not corrupting you right now. We're being sweet. Being sweet to you. So it's 7 in the afternoon. Oh, we've already picked it up that quickly. That's the fastest I've ever got one. I turned straight to the signal and started downloading it. Sounds like a star. Yeah. Oh, it's a planet. Yeah. Unknown signal type coming off of this outer planet. Did they, like, bust their face open, Yeet? Did they have blood?
She's huge!
She's our little fireball.
She is a plump little thing. I'm not just talking a little excess baby fat here. I'm talking, like, sideshow freak proportions. She's enormous!
Honey, please.
All right, Bill, I think we've got the point.
10 to 13, depending on who shows up. All right, that was another module decoding. Go ahead and drop the signal. I'm gonna analyze it after I look at what it did. I always like to see what my modules. I think that was another power nodule. No. Heat exchanger, maybe? Power core. That might have been the power core. I don't know. Can't always tell. But I will run the signal analyzer. What is it like to be the only male? You've gotten used to it. Have any more girls shown you attention? They're gonna always remember you as the guy that fucking did the class with all girls and lived to tell about it. So that Geiger counter's still going off. Thank you. Someone is DDoSing a Fuxnet site right now. I think he probably, it's enough just to use Cloudflare to fend off that type of attack. I asked him. Cloudflare, I use Cloudflare for my websites. And all it does is it keeps people from like directly accessing your IP address. I mean, God knows mine has been leaked, but that makes it a little bit harder to DDoS because they can't directly access your server. They have to go through Cloudflare's DNS. And then if they try to do a denial of service attack on you, Cloudflare detects it right away. They're like, oh no, people don't use websites like that. And then you can, they'll send you a notification or, oh look, I've already picked up the azimuth here while I was flapping my jaw. Oh, that's nice. I got a nice message from my friend. She's nice. Oh, there it is. That is a planetary, coreless planet. The planet has no core. But it's emitting radio waves. Sounds like some people I know. Yeah, chronicle.su is on Cloudflare. Not their cloud services, that's probably something different. Like, I don't use them as a content delivery network. Yeah, if they get your real IP though, Cloudflare won't do shit. In his case, he's got one additional mitigation layer that I probably shouldn't mention. But yeah, that's funny, that thing you said about like this, I forgot exactly the way you put it, but it was basically a menace in my voice, a hidden malice. Some people respond to that, like in real life, and those are my favorite kind of people because... Like, I went out with this girl one time, and she was like, you're funny. You're, like, really funny. And I don't think you realize that you're being funny. I'm like, no, you just appreciate it. That's nice. She was cool. Feels a little slow. Let me just check. Power's going to the server. I'm still radioactive. It's almost downloaded. I'll just find another video.
Ahead and do it. Yeah, come on, let's do it.
What's the young one?
What you come to do? Wait a minute, what's that you said?
What's
you
what?
Calling me a fool now? Is that it?
I didn't say
we're gonna
anything.
Have to damn shake the monkey one time on this sumbitch. Let's go.
I don't think I said anything.
Your eyes just did. Damn boy, you better convince them eyelids to get them eyes shut or they're about to get swelled.
God be with
hey,
you.
Hey, whoa, whoa, are you trying to cut me now? I got a witness. It is on. Backside on.
Just kill my daddy.
Son of a bitch. Coming up here on my property, trying to big boy early collar.
Oh, Baptist revival tomorrow night. Free juice.
Free juice? Where the hell did you get that?
Howdy, y'all. Guess who I just apprehended?
Oh, here it comes.
A dozen of my mama's gingerbread men, shaped just like yours truly.
It's nighttime now.
Whoop his eyes.
Look at that, boy.
Look at what?
Huh? I have to download the young one.
Roger!
Damn, they would have to fall frosting down.
Oh, Lord, I'm sorry, Sheriff. That was an accident.
Accident? Boy!
I mean, accident time on you. You fall on my fist with the face hurt. That's you, boy.
That's what I'm talking about. Hell yeah. Come on now. Turn it on, son. Turn it on.
Turn it on, son. Turn it on.
No. It's already on, okay? You got to tell him it's on.
It is on, boy.
Follow with the simile. Come on.
It's on like.
What's it on like? Preferably a rhyme.
It's on like.
What the
like
fuck is this? Why is it so loud?
Just stop, son.
Rusty, it's on like Red Dawn or Charles Bronson.
His DDoS lasted 15 minutes. He said it's on.
But Michelle Kwan, please.
She made sacrifices to get where she is.
Damn it. How many times have we watched Roadhouse this weekend? How many times, Rusty? Huh? How damn many?
Four?
Film, that's a lot. We love hell out of that movie film. But why, son? Why?
Because Patrick Swayze lives his life like a real man, asses is kicked, names is taken, love is made.
Man, commercial.
Y'all know he's starting a film festival up here, don't you? Just like Sundance, only this one's called Dirty Dance.
Why wouldn't he just call it Roadhouse?
Well, you can ask him yourself. He's dead.
Patrick Swayze from the moving picture for the television Roadhouse? In the flesh?
The one in the same.
Patrick Swayze.
He's smaller in real life.
James! Hey, it's all right.
What's your latest project?
You see this soffit over this vent pipe? I'm changing it into a sunrise.
Okay.
The kid got punched right in the balls.
The bars back in here, right?
Hey, old man, I thought I told you. It's my way or the highway.
This is mine and Yeet's culture.
This boy don't seem like Swayze to me.
Oh, yeah? Hey, you remember in Roadhouse when I bought that crappy car and bought some extra tires? Because I knew someone was going to cut my tires outside the Double Deuce. Sure enough, that happened. And I changed the tires, and I drove away. Remember that?
Yep.
That was me.
Oh, my God almighty! It is him, Patrick Swayze! It is an honor to meet you. Patrick, I know you must get this all the time, but... If you wouldn't be too much trouble to you, would you please drop a Double Deuce ass whooping on my boy?
Well, of course, I'd be delighted.
Daddy, what you doing?
Hold his arms
Daddy,
for me.
This ain't right.
Take your movie whooping like a man.
Oh, my dear, my lovely, I hunger for those
Patrick.
Fries.
Patrick.
Those crazy
Patrick.
Roadhouse
fries. Cut you off. And I love your backdrop, don't get me wrong. It's very evocative of the period, but it does lack a certain bricks and mortar quality.
I'm from Texas.
Oh,
I ride horses.
Yeah, I know that, but these guys here, they ride horses for a living. That's kind of the reason we have to keep a close rein.
I'm the cooler, you're the bouncer.
And you've mentioned that. You have, a lot. But if you
Hey, old man! It's my highway, or it's that way, my way. Let's take it outside. I'm from Texas.
Are you guys that I got?
Going out in the middle of the night. Oh, it's a full moon. Look how bright it is. Where's number 16? Out that way? I'll go check on the rover, too, since I'm going this way. Whoops. The rover should be out here somewhere. Unless it got abducted by aliens. Oh no, maybe it's way over there. Whoa, oh no, I'm wrecking. Gosh, that's so disorienting. Look at these big hills. Have these always been here? Is there like a spaceship underground? Under these mountains? What the fuck are these mountains? I don't remember those. Seems like I would remember those. See, 19, 18, 17. That one's probably 16. I would remember some fucking mountains, dude. Is this game gaslighting me? Yeah, this is 16. It's a beautiful night. I'll calibrate it while I'm here. It's one that needed it.
Hmm.
I don't remember those fucking mountains. I mean, it's not a mountain. It's just a big hill. I don't mean to make a mountain out of a hill. I'll download The Young Ones. Is that a British sketch comedy? I like Monty Python. Monty Python's Flying Circus. But I guess to you guys, that's like... I don't know. Might as well be Saturday Night Live or something, right? I think I see the rover. Like, it's just so... At this point, it's so built into your culture. It's like, yeah, we get it. Monty Python's Flying Circus. It was hilarious. We've all already laughed at it, so... It's not going to surprise you. You're almost there, Rover. Can I hit this rock? No. Okay. I bet that storm made my solar panels dirty, because they're only getting 78% efficiency. And I think it's the module upgrades that are adding my solar panels. Like, I'm not buying any module upgrades. I'm just earning them through scanning. I watched a good documentary this morning on the anti-corporate themes of Alien. It was very interesting. Still got this radiation warning. I'm loving it, enjoying it really. Damn, this is a fun game. I feel like I've got another story one coming up soon, because I've been scanning and scanning. Not that I don't enjoy everything in between. Really, the story stuff gets scary. It's like Resident Evil when you start to fucking unfold the horror. I've been in suspense for a week now. Like, what's gonna happen next? Thank you. got these antennae rotating so fast that you can watch them rotate now. Yards or meters or whatever the hell. I think it's meters. Really going off now. All the time now. It's like the closer I get to this signal, that thing is going ham. It's solid on. Okay. Got the azimuth dialed in pretty quick. Something, man. I hear things. That door locked. What happened with your roommate? I'm hearing something so weird come through this little speaker. It's making extra sound. I can hear something moving, like almost like a. There's a microphone on and there's somebody clicking against it or something. That's not just the clicking of the Geiger counter. There's another sound going on there. It's extra. Oh, here it comes. I've got the signal. Power from the antenna to the server, and we're going to download. It's a Mega Earth playing. planet. This is a radio wave emission. Yeah, there's something extra going on. It's downloading fast. We're gonna get it right now. All right, just garbled nonsense, and it's morning. Is there more to the punching story? .276, .22. This one's pretty close, it'll be fast. All the way down to 18. It's making extra sounds, man. I swear it is. I'm not like trying to be funny or be cute. Pretending to hear things I don't hear. I'm not trying to be a streamer. That thing's just really making extra sound. 281.17, I'll stop there. I go as low as I can, and then I go forward. Here comes my helicopter. It's gonna get loud. Might interfere with the broadcast signal. Or what is this? It's a mega Earth? Mega Earth sounds scary, dude. Like, they would have, like, 20 trillion people. I heard something. I heard something extra. I heard a banging. What's up with your, that's funny, dude, how there's you come back to paragraphs of somebody just dumping in the public Discord. Everyone's, like, obligated to read that. Where did I start? 17? I don't think I started there. Shipping out military duty. Yeah, the Hey Guys energy, like, I feel like it's easy to get into that. It's a place of insecurity, just filling the air with noise. Hey guys, what's up, YouTube? That's a bad one. You hear this shit? Of course you hear it. It's fucking loud as hell. There goes my helicopter. Alright, this is a good one. This is my rare earth shit. Yeah. That's coming from a place. Oh, this is unknown repeating radio signal. It changed. Oh my god, I hear something else too. I gotta walk away from the terminal. Oh no, that's part of the signal that. Jesus. What a weird signal this is. Things are about to get weird, man. Yeah, people like that, they have no shame, dude. They have no dignity. They'll grovel and beg and after fucking embarrassing themselves with obsession. Here it comes, 10%. This is going to be a weird one. Unknown. I will never come back to Earth. Okay. Heard enough of that. Let's see if we can analyze that signal any better. No. That's as good as it gets. Alright, so that was a story. That was a storyline. Signal. I will never return to Earth. So I think someone has been abducted, maybe? Is what I could deduce from that. Or sometimes this doesn't feel like Earth to me. Like, I don't know if that's just a design choice, but. Like, the weather's really weird. It gets super hot and then it gets cold. I don't know. And then, like, there's that object outside that's all the time watching me. Like, I'll just go up here and... And one time I saw something white floating off in the distance, but I didn't have a chance to get the telescope and look at it. You can see where all the antenna are pointed. Whatever I heard was out that way. There's this smudge right on my monitor, right next to that white dot. There we go. Okay, I'll get in the rover. Oh, I bet I got a lot of credit for that I just did. And I need to examine this. I gotta download the young ones. I'll do that on my laptop later. Oh, it's raining. My Geiger counter's still going off. That was an extra noise I just heard. I'm starting to hear extra noises I've never heard before. Got fuel? Got something. Whatever. Give me some credits. Got money for upgrades. I always upgrade my coordinates so that I get the coordinates fastest. Let's see, what time is it? It's noon. Said he's recharging. I just need to get back to scanning, really.
Plate on your head somehow picks up certain high-frequency radio waves. At least that's the theory of the Army Medical Examiner.
But the Martians, they want to stop the moon rocket.
And it's from another world. Colonel, you can't really believe that. You must have misunderstood. The real enemies are the Eastern Alliance. But their agents have been caught. Their moon project won't take place for a long time as a result. You just take it easy, sir. The Army is going to track down that wavelength above your head. The music is ready.
Might upgrade this polarizer next. Oh my god, what the fuck was that? Oh, that's the radio. Fuck that radio. Scaring me. Gee, dude, this game is scary. That's good enough. Hey Brian, yeah, the TV plays VHS tapes. Local files. I wonder if you could point to like a server file. Because as long as it was a file, it seems like it might work. This shit turns fast now, dude. It's like already there. Okay. And I'm finding my azimuth already, so that's cool. I'll be downloading soon. Hearing extra sound. This is another coreless planet. Downloading really fast, 9 megabytes per second. That's good. What surprises me is how large these files are. 1.3 gigs of audio? It must be like really high quality audio, like the highest quality there is. Looks like the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Yeah, it's Event Horizon. He's thinking about his wife who killed herself. Super creepy movie, man. I have watched this movie, I don't know how many times. Server's hot again. I don't know what is too hot for the server, but I never let it get over 50. I mean, it's not like it costs extra power. I can run those turbo fans all day, every day. Thank you.
heard nowhere else. Visit us on the web at...
This is probably just more bullshit. If it's a module upgrade, it's still worth it. And sometimes I have to run the signal analyzer. But usually it's nothing, and you just gotta keep scanning. I upgraded my polarization, I'm gonna see the difference now. I can't tell the difference. I guess I'm going faster, I don't know. I go as low as it might even accidentally hit. 30. All right, that's good. Yeah, that fucking thing. Like this, it just feels like not Earth. And I don't know if that's just because I'm playing a video game. And of course it's not Earth. But I kind of feel like that thing is just monitoring me the whole time. There's my rover. I gotta find another meteorite impact for the rover to survey. Oh, there it is. Now what you can do is just reset the position and... I mean, thank God for that. You don't have to move it from where it sits. I tried to move the rover into the fucking... where all those open eggs are, and I couldn't go in that door. Because I wanted to stick that arm right into the fucking egg and analyze it, but it wouldn't let me. But here you can just reset the position. It takes you back to the beginning. And there it is. Like, I just go forward now. That's the easiest yet. All right. Oh, here's a scary part.
Really? I'm so cold.
Tits, great shot right there. Down blouse. Okay. Stop that signal. Wait a minute. No, no, I fucked up. Oh no. Alright. I gotta start over. Shit. God damn it. I dropped the fucking signal. because I was fucking around, watching horror, eating edibles. I'd be a terrible SETI guy. I remember being little and seeing the footage from NASA, and they all looked like awesome, like hippie dudes with beards and shit. Like, you could tell that it smelled like marijuana at NASA. And now I wonder if that's still the culture. $1.44. It's not too bad. I fucked up. They're all on ketamine. Yeah, I wonder if there is some kind of culture of fetishization for Elon at NASA, or if it's just like, or if they're in our ballpark where they're like skeptical, I guess. Skepticism. That's healthy. 46, 197. Come up one. Okay. Shit, antenna 16 has to be fucking reset again. Okay. How close are they to getting there?
I got up, packed the car, and headed for the nearest town, Hudsonville, about 10 miles to the south. They'd take care of me in Hudsonville. Consider, if you will, the case of the rat that once inhabited Christmas Island, a small bit of tropical verdure some 200 miles south of Java. In 1903, a new disease sprang up. The rats proved universally susceptible and soon were dying by the thousands. In spite of great numbers, in spite of an abundant supply of food, in spite of a rapid breeding rate, the species is now extinct.
My system efficiency is 100%.
Stores, taverns, but no one on the streets. A hen scratched quietly in the dust. A lonely dog was howling somewhere. I got out of the car and walked into a little restaurant. The place was empty.
I always keep the lights off in here. I love how it looks. All right, so we've already found the azimuth. And the elevation. That was quick. .36. That might be the highest download rate yet. keeping the video going, it adds an atmosphere of its own. It's a pretty normal radio wave emission. Doesn't sound weird. Pretty much, I'm pretty used to this. 7:15 at night. Yeah, they probably are more into the specific designer names. Because, like, Elon went to the cream of the crop, and he got engineers and designers working more directly with the project than most people at most companies will. Like, they'll have however many thousands of engineers, but the same number are still touching the final product. So I got this itchy bump the other day on my face, and now it's just this hard bump, a red, and it hurts to touch. It's cancer. Just another empty signal. I'll run the analyzer though, because I got a couple, every few signals I'll run the analyzer. Yep, there it is, module schematics, that's good. Oh, another one. 2 for 2. Don't mind if I do. Let's see what happened. I think my data came up. The coordination came up. The rotors came up. Another solar cell, maybe? Okay. And what more upgrades can I do? There's some stuff I just don't care about, and I don't upgrade it at all. The generator, I don't give a shit. The calibration is a good one. I hate having to recalibrate. I'll buy that one. Oh, there's that sound. My heart fucking skips a beat when I hear that. You had to have heard it that time. It's like a croaking sound, sort of. Like a purring, croaking sound. Like, I'm not getting any more radiation, though. That's good. Thank you. another bright night. In here. See, even after upgrading these, oh, here we go. They're not all that sensitive yet. Okay, this is an unknown signal. Hot in my room. I'm gonna open the door. Billy's off work. I guess we're about to play Sea of Thieves. I was gonna buy it, but I don't think it's worth $40, really. At least not to me. I might like it, though. A dollar is better. Okay. I love dropping the signal. Fuck you, signal. Yeah, if I really like it, I think that it's a great opportunity to try it, because I did want to try it, and a dollar is hard to beat. Dude, that's my 40th signal. And I've had 4 storyline signals. So it's about every 10 you get one. And I've got all this stuff stored up, but I don't know how to use it. How do I use my transmitters? Interstellar communicators? What the fuck is that, you know? How do I use that? Is that a module I need? No? Here are my databases. But what are event signals? No data. So there's an event signal that it seems even rarer than a story signal. Is that rain I hear? What do I hear? Wind, I guess. It must be wind. Oh yeah, it's gusty. 50 something kilometers. Oh, and it's about to be a blizzard. Yeah, that's a lot of games, dude. What happens if I drop my subscription? Does it have to go through some kind of a verification thing? And it's like, you can't play that anymore. Or if I keep it installed and then I drop the subscription, what happens then? It just won't start. Okay. But I can still play with you guys. Yeah, as long as, like, it's all through Microsoft. Is that the deal? Or does the game have its own way of knowing who you are? That's an iconic shot right there. Justin with his back to that thing. Ultimate science fiction shot. All right, we're losing power, so I what time is it? Midnight? It won't really do any good to clean those things now. I'll have to clean them in the morning. All right, might go to sleep. Oh, so even if you get it on Steam, yeah, you have to log in through a Microsoft account. I gotcha. Looks like sleep advances the game. 8 hours. Now that little alien dude, he appears after a certain point. You don't start with that little sticky note. And I guess the story would go that I made that and stuck it there, like after I detected my first one. I don't know. Hey, LMAO. And he's saying Quapla. And it's showing a crash. Okay. Oh, let me pull up my account really quick. I never spend much time in this server room. Oh, there went the power blinking. Ah, shit. I drove it into one of these. Is it stuck? It's fucking stuck, man. Yeah, I'm pulling it up real quick. Thorny or Drake, 86. Beast World. Sorry for dead naming. Join us if you want. Yeet might have disappeared before I could give him my name. And we could use a fourth. You can buy that Game Pass thing. I assume it's the same in the UK. Maybe you buy a... You pay a pound for the first month if you want to play with us. A quid. Which I guess is friending. Yeah, I don't have friends. I have followers. Oh, there's a 3-person boat too. Nice. I'd love to do a full 4-man go. Go, man, go. Why won't it turn left? Am I stuck on something? What's to the left over here? It won't turn left. It's like a faulty left control or something. I might drive out there and look at it. So if Billy's home, are we playing right now? Are we about to play? We about to play. All power to the server. Turn everything else off. We about to play. Yeah, I'm ready. I'll go through the process and install it and everything. That scared
me. This is CBS, where you spend an hour with Frank Sinatra every Sunday afternoon on the Columbia Broadcasting System.
Nice. I'm drifting.
For stories of the strange and
Oh, there it is, way out there. So I just gotta point slightly to the left of this water tower. Yeah, that's it. Okay. I should be clear of my solar array now. Oh, I forgot to clean the fucking solar panels. That's why I went out there. Whatever. Oh, I can't see the tower. There it is. All right, that's it. I'm gonna turn this shit off and join you guys playing Sea of Thieves. If you're still listening, thanks for hanging out. I'm fucking around. I'm HateSec. Follow me on twitter.com/HateSec. Go fuck yourself.